key. What could it be for? The garden shed? Carl couldn't reach it with his arm alone, but he had more than a few tricks up his sleeve to pick it up. That truck had obviously seen its share of gravel roads. Carl wasn't a mechanic, but he could easily tell that only the most heartfelt prayer would bring this old beater back from its slumber. With that cold, however, it was more likely that it would wait until next spring to wake up. The place looked more like a pigsty than a house. A heavy stench of curdled milk, cheap alcohol, and boiled cauliflower filled the air. Back then, in Africa and elsewhere, people were ready to take up arms to stand against the yoke of English imperialism. In Montreal, mailboxes were blown up, abductions were carried out, and violent manifestos were distributed to media outlets. But around here, in the great northernmost, all a man could do is curse out loud against a faraway evil and pray for the revolution to arise. That man, by any reckoning, was from that very stock. Ray Jean Blouin. Seems like that pig had a name after all. Rock music invaded the minds of men even in the remotest of places. The man didn't own a turntable though, so there's that going for him. You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home. The all-surrounding stench of alcohol alone was probably enough to gas a man to death. The rag reeked of fermented vomit. Carl wondered how one could bear to live in such gross and horrid conditions. At any point wished to get his hands on some caribou, he couldn't have wished for... for better than a distillery like this one. With a homemade shooting range such as this, it wasn't hard to imagine a stray bullet ending its course inside the flesh of an unsuspecting passerby. Granted, Carl thought, there wasn't much in the way of passersby around here. Garbage trucks rarely made a stop in the area. Thankfully, the lake served as a pretty good backup dump for those times when the bins started overflowing. Thank you. Sometimes, and especially around here, people are so possessive with their land as a dog is with hydrants. Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold. Another worrisome victim of this ice, this one seemingly petrified in action. The poor man, before being frozen solid, seemed to have been defending the entrance to his cabin. But from what? The very first steps of man on the moon were made more than a year ago. The event had surely captivated the mechanic's mind for him to still keep this around. Something very important must have been in there for the man to take such time and effort to hide it. But Carl didn't know how to reach it. Well, this truck's not going anywhere. Where were the amputated parts? Carl grinned as he pictured a Frankenstein-esque car lying around somewhere made of parts from a dozen different vehicles. The milk was sorted by color, from the whitest to the greenest, or in other words, from the freshest to the sourest. Weird stuff. Kind of a crossing between a colander and a hairdryer. What was it for? To play telepath? To protect against nuclear waves? Roswell, Atamipek, same story. Large deserts conducive to extravagant follies. If some daring person could manage to get their hands on the missing parts, Carl was willing to bet that the craft would have taken flight. Nice catio. They say it's supposed to soothe the soul. But with this powerful gale that seemingly never sleeps, it was far more likely to get on anyone's nerves. By following the plan, Carl was led to believe that the snowmobile's parts had to be scattered about in the vicinity. Carl hadn't lived up to his good finder reputation. He still hadn't found any of the wealth contained in Lamotte's lands. It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore. The shape of this machine, almost straight out of Star Trek, was out of the ordinary to say the least. It felt like this thing could fly up into space at any moment. An indisputable fact that machines like this entailed a level of intellectual finesse that Carl was lacking. To all appearances, Carl concluded, the owner of the place had moved more essentials from his house inside the garage. Peculiar man indeed.
Thank you.
Never thought he would be dancing with the wolves. The blood and the shape of the hole in the ground left no room for doubt. Someone had been buried here. Someone whose life had been taken with blunt force. Where was the body now? Why had it been buried, only to be dug up later? Carl felt as though he was shrouded in fog.